This is Terry Kurtz Online, reporting on Victor Valley, High Desert, and Mojave River Valley events, activities, entertainment, sports, and history. The weekend of July 11, 2014, Carlotta Diggs presents this musical extravaganza featuring an all-star ensemble of outstanding talented entertainers from throughout the High Desert. Terry Kurtz Online was brought to you by Down Home Grill in Victorville on the corner of Bear Valley Road and Ridgecrest Road.
Go!
Bid fast and last, sold on supporting High Desert Sports. Valu quality truck body, family owned and operated since 1954. The Bradco Companies, our area's longest standing full service commercial brokerage firm. Iwanzak Law Firm, trial lawyers for serious problems. And by the Community Table Restaurant in the Holiday Inn in Victorville. The Holiday Inn, favored destination for travelers and visitors to the Victor Valley. Terry Kurtz here, throwing out an invitation for you to catch up with High Desert Sports Activities. Your High Desert Sports Report, showing three times every day on Victor Valley TV. 7 and 11 every morning, 4 every afternoon.
What time is it, sports fan?
It's time for your
your half-hour High Desert Sports Report, the area's only video action highlights coverage of high school athletes, teams, and sports programs, Victor Valley College Rams, and Barstow College Vikings athletic events. We hope you'll join us right here on Victor Valley TV. Improving students' communications skills is a high priority in the Apple Valley Unified School District's mission to prepare every student for their future. One arena in which students display their ability to communicate effectively, Skills USA competition.
Hi, my name is Kimberly Flores, and I am part of the Apple Valley High School Skills USA chapter.
My name is Karina Torres, and I go to Apple Valley High School.
Hi, I'm Daisy Dominguez, and I am part of the Apple Valley Skills USA chapter. I'm competing in community service.
These students volunteer as hospice care providers in an after-school program and compete in the SkillsUSA Community Service category.
Well, a typical day would be meet up after school in the van. We get there and we meet up in a conference room, and then we would get assigned patients, and we spend a maximum of an hour with the patient.
I'm helping the elderly smile and getting them through the day, since sometimes they don't want to be in the hospice facility. And so, like, when they're there and they don't, like, they're all down. And so when we get there, we bring a smile to their faces. And statistically shown, smiling can increase your lifetime. So it really impacts the community and the elderly.
And we'll do, we could do a series of things. We could read books. If it was a lady, will paint their nails, nail care.
What I enjoy most is interacting with the patients and getting to know them and their history. They're very interesting.
And after we're done with our patient, we'll go and help the other care providers. We could help them set up like the dinner, put bibs on the patient. And then after we're done visiting with our patients that we have assigned, we will go back to the conference room where we will document everything that we did with our patients, all the activities that we did.
Well, since I do want to go into the medical field, it benefits me on having hands-on experience with patients and nurses, so I'm prepared for the future.
Hi, my name is Dr. Gonzalez.
Itzel Gonzalez competes in SkillsUSA baking. This is her fourth year in SkillsUSA. Last year, she advanced to state. In her leadership presentation, the Apple Valley senior tells she has Down syndrome.
I have Down syndrome. I work in a really, real hard.
She has a part-time job.
I work at a restaurant. I work at Mama Cappino.
And reveals her future plans to attend college and eventually open her own bakery.
I want to go to college, open my own bakery.
Competing in SkillsUSA is just one ingredient in this outstanding student's recipe for preparing for her future.
I work in really, really hard.
High-profile student athletes in Apple Valley Unified School District High Schools have been standing out head and shoulders above the competition, one might say. Brilani Bell of Granite Hills has worked to lead the Lady Cougars to a CIF playoff berth a second year in a row. Excerpts from this report demonstrate the 6'3 senior's articulate communication skills. Brilani Bell scores 12 points, 10 in the second half. What were she and the Lady Cougars told by first-year coach Ashley McLeod at halftime?
She told us to keep pushing, even though, like, we had our ups and downs. Just keep it together. Don't overplay. Don't slow down. Just keep pushing. And then it turned out well, and we all ended up scoring, and ended up great.
Jordan Brooks is the tallest of the Apple Valley Lady Sun Devils. The 6'5", Jordan Brooks averages 14 rebounds a game in her sophomore season, a pace that could lead to her setting a career rebounding record.
Hello, my name is Sonia Hinkle, and I'm a greatest student at Granite Hills High School.
This Granite Hills senior explains how the Great Academy, Granite Hills High School, Granite Recording and Entertainment Arts Training, prepares students interested in a career in these fields.
Well, we're the first school, I'm pretty sure, in the high desert that has this type of academy, which is, it bases itself on, like, performing arts aspects. So theater production, video production, acting, stage design, clothes design, makeup design, all of it bases around the theater that we have built in at the school.
What do you like best?
I'm a techie myself, so I'm very involved in video production and lighting and sound.
Granite Hills has been designated a model school for its great program.
Yes, the California Department of Education has selected Granite Hills High School and specifically our Great Academy. It's been designated as an AME, which is Arts, Media, and Entertainment, model demo school. So what that means is that all of the high schools in California can come and take a look at what our program is, what we're doing here insofar as curriculum, organization, class offerings, partnerships that we've established with the community and businesses, and then they can use that as a model to take back to their areas and try to implement those programs.
School is out, summer vacation, but there is no vacation for administrators in attempts to correct problems in public school education. What contributed to the decline in education in California in decades past?
I think it's a multitude of many things. It's the eras that we grew up in. But California's changed dramatically. It doesn't look the same as when you and I were students. The job market has changed dramatically. Global market has changed dramatically. California has increased in size dramatically, diversity dramatically. And so really rethinking what is our purpose in education, and the fact that we've changed what kids have to know and be able to do has changed dramatically just in light of where the jobs are. A technical education is critical. What these kids know today and have to do to graduate from high school doesn't look the same as when you and I graduated from high school. The number of units, the types of classes they're required to take. And about 30 years ago, they got rid of a lot of the career technical education. And in my opinion, that was a mistake, because while academic preparation is essential, if you can't apply it, it doesn't do you a lot of good. And I think we are moving back into recognizing the importance of career technical education, making sure that kids are academically prepared but also can apply those skills is the right track. And I'm very glad to see that we're back to increasing that part of our role. But it's really hard for kids to be able to get some of those classes because of all the other academic requirements. Academics, very important. Application, I think, is equally important, whether you're going to be a doctor or an engineer, or whether you're going to be a designer, or you're going to be a technician. I think all kids need that rounded education, and I think providing those opportunities will put us back in place. That costs money, and the state is going to have to continue to invest in and capitalize in the types of equipment our teachers need to provide those opportunities for students. Without capitalization specifically for those kinds of programs, that will continue to hamper us compared to other states.
The private sector continues to provide tremendous assistance to public school education, particularly in the areas of science and technology. Apple Valley Rancho's Water Company and High Desert Underground announced a donation of $7,500 to Granite Hills High School for Scott Weldy System Control and Design Academy scholarships. Scott Weldy was a 17-year employee of and former vice president and general manager of Rancho's, who worked closely with SCADA teachers and was instrumental in developing the SCADA program and curriculum. He died in 2014. The idea for SCADA began with Scott Weldy, and next year, Granite Hills expects to have 160 students enrolled in the academy.
The acronym stands for System Control and Design Academy, and basically it's a preparation for work.
SCADA is directed to students looking for a hands-on approach to learning and career application. Scholarships will be awarded to graduates who have completed the SCADA curriculum and intend to pursue higher education or a vocation in engineering, environmental science, or a technical position within the water industry.
Victor Valley College Board President Joseph W. Brady offers the timetable for construction of the VVC Education Center and begins by explaining why construction does not involve adding another bond measure.
Well, Terry, in the last month, back in April, the Board of Trustees approved the sale of up to $35 million worth of additional bonds. So people would say, well, I thought you already did that years ago. We did. We had a bond offering back in 2006 that offered $297 million. But you end up selling these in chunks as you need them. So we looked at the bond rating, we looked at what the cost of this facility would be, went out to the marketplace, and the market raised $31 million immediately for this facility. The architect is LPA, very well known out of Irvine. The team out at VBC has done a great job working with all the different groups on the campus, the athletic groups, to see how we can do this. The centerpiece is three rooms that can be combined together, so we could seat 592 people for a meal. What's nice is that we're going to be able to use it for athletic, for football games. So there's going to be, you know, up-to-date bathrooms. You're going to be able to come in off the football field. On the side that we currently, that the Student Activity Center is on top of the hill, the new configuration shows a press box and seating for 3,500 into the hill. So the football stadium basically moves, I don't know, probably maybe 50 yards, I'm guessing, away from Fish Hatchery Road for safety. That side where Fish Hatchery Road will have up to 1,500 seats for visitors. So we'll have 3,500, and then down where I would call the southern part of the field, down towards Bear Valley Road, will be this structure that has a lot of glass. It's gorgeous. It has multiple rooms to be able to use. The center area is going to be where the board will meet. We'll have a room in the back for a closed session. You can do seminars out there. You can do conferences out there. It's going to be available to the public. You could do weddings in there. You could do birthday parties. This is going to be a facility that the entire High Desert of Mojave River Valley is going to be really proud to have, and it's going to be something that is going to be very functional. And then you'll have these multiple rooms that you can use for, you know, dinners, conferences, seminars. So, Terry, I'm excited. The team at VBC is hoping to, Dr. Wallen's hoping to get this submitted to DSA by the end of this year. They figure it'll take about 6 months to get through the approvals up there, the plan check, and then hopefully start construction and hopefully be done by fourth quarter of 2022. So it's one of those things that as you take a look at the real feel of how the college has come from the one stop, you know, we are really progressing building by building. People wonder why it takes so long to do this stuff. One, you have to be able to substantiate it. Two, you have to be able to pay for it. Three, you know, we know that brick and mortar is changing every day, whether it be on retail or education. So you need to be sure these buildings are used right. But this is going to be a great addition. We're now taking a look at, you know, what is the potential for student housing out there someday. We believe that with student housing, we can not only increase our enrollment, but we could also increase the success that we have as a community college. It increases that interaction with students to be around an educational atmosphere all the time. I mean, I remember when I went to Cal Poly, I was on campus. I mean, you feel like you're in that educational world, and it makes you feel good. So, you know, again, with Dr. Walden's help and his management team and John Nollins and Peter M., we call him, R. Lopez, we are just really blessed with a great group. And I think Dr. Walden has, you know, with the help of his predecessor, Dr. Wagner, really brought in great talent, got the talent that he somewhat inherited when he got here. And he's really he's getting the best out of everybody. So I'll tell you, it's a great time to be a trustee of Victor Valley College, and it's a great time to work with the other trustees that we got. I know that we're all totally committed to this project, so.
The Bradco Companies present This Date in High Desert and Mojave River Valley Sports History.
Isaiah Kepley, Victor Valley Jackrabbits. Jill Wiersbicki, Granite Hills Cougars. Aaron Guinan, Hesperia Christian Patriots. Matt Mesner, Apple Valley Christian Warriors. 2011 Gabrielson Memorial Foundation Scholarship Winners. These four scholarship recipients from the 30 Senior Athletes of the Year, representing the 15 high schools in the Victor Valley. Kepley, one day sums it up. Most valuable player in the All-Star football game. Later that day, most valuable player All-Star basketball game.
It'll be great. It's a great honor just to be nominated for this award. It'll be something good to bring back to Victor Valley.
Where's Vicky? 4 years All-CIF in softball, first team All-CIF soccer, High Desert Soccer Player of the Year.
I was very honored. I was very lucky to be nominated, so I'm just very glad that I even got nominated, so.
Guinan, All-CIF basketball for the Lady Patriots. Favorite memories?
We kind of always have this rivalry between the volleyball team and the football team of who works harder and, you know, who has more fun together. So we kind of like to sabotage each other when we have our gym sleepovers. We actually snuck in and we saran wrapped all their stuff together and threw confetti and everything. So that was a lot of fun.
Messner, captain Warriors volleyball, basketball, and golf teams, all league, all three sports. His brother, a Gabrielson Scholarship winner earlier.
Yeah, it was a great pleasure to be able to win this award after my brothers won it. We have another one coming up, so maybe a third.
All athletes of the year received awards. C.J. Hintz, Victor Valley Christian Volleyball, Basketball, and Softball. T.V. Holland, Lucerne Valley All-League Basketball, Volleyball, and Softball. Brandy Ladeau, Riverside Prep, All-League Volleyball, Silver Knights Soccer Team Captain. Amber Lopetrella, AAE Softball and Soccer, All-League Both Sports, AAE ASB President. Luiana Salazar, Excelsior Four Sports Star, Basketball, Golf, Volleyball, and Track and Field. Sonique Takborian, Apple Valley Christian, Volleyball, Basketball, Softball. Nikki Burnaby, Apple Valley Soccer Team Captain, represented Sun Devils receiving CIF Sportsmanship Award. Daquana Harris, Victor Valley 4-year track star and basketball standout, Defensive Player of the Year all 4 years. Sophia LaBrosse, Oak Hills, All-League Volleyball, Team Captain, leading the Bulldogs to the school's first league championship. Jashe Lee set 8 Sultana school records in basketball. 4-year starter, league MVP, All-CIF. Sarah Layton, Hesperia Scorpions, Volleyball Most Valuable Player and All-League Performer. Softball standout. Rachel Lewis, Silverado, Volleyball and Track, and led Hawks to league championship her senior year. Hawks Award winner for top grade point average. Katie Pound, Serrano, West Point bound, All-CIF Soccer 3 straight years. Katie, among the awards winners, throwing out the first pitch at the Mavericks game Memorial Day Monday.
So it's special to me, and the whole thing, like going to West Point and being part of the Army, and it's just kind of doing something for all the people who've lost their lives.
Chris Bellinger, Excelsior, All-CIF football, defensive end, basketball, and track standout for the Eagles. Josh Cruz, Lucerne Valley, Mustangs football all-star, 3-time league champion in wrestling. Randy Groover, AAE, 2-time league basketball most valuable player. Craig Hollinsby, Hesperia Christian football, baseball, and track. Another ceremonial first pitch participant, Memorial Day Monday. Jordan Moss, Victor Valley Christian, quarterback to the Royals football team, basketball and baseball leader. Daniel Steger, Riverside Prep, baseball standout, and led Silver Knights to school's first basketball championship. Brett Croft, Oak Hills Bulldogs, soccer team captain 2 years, tennis, cross country, football, and track. Mike Gonzalez, Sultana, CIF wrestling champion, 3-time Mojave River League champion, undefeated in home dual meets. Mike also ran cross country and track. Madison Maddie Kendrick, Serrano, started at 5 positions in soccer, top tennis duels player. Gabrielson characteristics of team first, foremost, and Maddie's grade point average, 4.9. Jimmy Musgrave, Silverado. Look up linebacker in the football dictionary and Musgrave's picture appears. First team All-CIF, top all-around student athlete in Hawks school history.
Jose Luis Quezada Jr., Hesperia, highest graded Scorpions defensive lineman, all league, High Desert All-Star, leader of the defensive unit, wrestler, track and field. Nick Reynolds, Apple Valley, led Sun Devils to 4 consecutive track and field league championships, set Sun Devils records in hurdles, captained cross country and soccer teams as well. Omar Ross, Granite Hills, heavyweight wrestler, all-league defensive lineman. Only Gabrielson Award winner unable to attend, Omar recuperating from knee surgery. 2011 title sponsor, Ryan and Ross McAkron, RMAC Insurance. Gabrielson Awards Senior Athletes of the Year, named by their school's athletic director. Now well over 200 of this area's best of the best, honored and recognized over the years. Over 50 recipients of Gabrielson Memorial Foundation scholarships. And more to follow, thanks in large part to the generous sponsorship of ISU Insurance, RMAC. The Gabrielson Memorial Fund is a proud affiliate of the High Desert Community Foundation. Rick Gabrielson Memorial Foundation Athletes of the Year Award winners were recognized in pregame ceremonies Memorial Day Monday at the High Desert Mavericks baseball game. Particularly fitting was the participation by Gabrielson Award winners bound for military careers.
Yes, and the whole thing, like going to West Point and being part of the Army, and it's just kind of doing something for all the people who've lost their lives and all that, so it's special to me.
Katie Pound of the Serrano Diamondbacks was all CIF 3 years in soccer. She has a full scholarship to West Point, where she'll continue playing soccer.
My grandfather was a United States Marine for 20 years, and he ended up as a Chief Warrant Officer, Chief Warrant Officer 1, and he's a 20-year Marine, and I just wanted to honor him through my life, as well as through my entire family's life as a United States Marine, and I plan to go on to Point Loma Nazarene to do the NROTC program and also become a Marine.
Craig Hollinsby pitched for the Patriots of Hesperia Christian, and was a standout in football and track.
Strike 2 on the outside corner.
Isaiah Kepley, all-CIF first team in football, broke every pass receiving record for the Victor Valley Jackrabbits. He was all-star football game most valuable player and all-star basketball game most valuable player the same day, a defining punctuation mark to conclude his prep athletic career. The Rick Gabrielson Memorial Foundation presents awards to 30 high school senior athletes of the year. 4 award winners are recipients of a $1,000 scholarship.
Terry Kurtz here, throwing out an invitation for you to catch up with High Desert Sports Activities, your High Desert Sports Report, showing 3 times every day on Victor Valley TV, 7 and 11 every morning, 4 every afternoon.
What time is it, sports fan?
It's time for your High Desert Sports Report!
Your half hour High Desert Sports Report, the area's only video action highlights coverage of high school athletes, teams, and sports programs, Victor Valley College Rams, and Barstow College Vikings athletic events. We hope you'll join us right here on Victor Valley TV. Terry Kurtz Online was brought to you by Down Home Grill in Victorville on the corner of Bear Valley Road and Ridgecrest Road.
Go.
Bid fast and last, sold on supporting High Desert Sports. Midway Home Solutions in Victorville. Deagle and Dodd always has discount prices on appliances, mattresses, home furnishings, and electronics. Valu quality truck bodies. Family owned and operated since 1954. The Bradco Companies, our area's longest standing full service commercial brokerage firm. Iwanzak Law Firm, trial lawyers for serious problems. and by the Community Table Restaurant in the Holiday Inn in Victorville. The Holiday Inn, favored destination for travelers and visitors to the Victor Valley.
Terry Kurtz here online. Thank you for watching.